Welcome to today's class. Myself, K. Manjula, Assistant Professor of Physics, Dr. B.R.R. Government Degree College, Jatchalra, Mahbub Nagar District. Coming to today's class, let us continue our yesterday's topic, that is aberrations. In the yesterday's class, we have discussed about introduction to aberrations and types of aberrations, the reason for arising of these aberrations in optical system. So there are two types of aberrations, that is when white light is used, the chromatic aberration arises. Even though in place of white light, if we use monochromatic light, depending upon the optical system, some other defects also arises. Those are astigmatism, coma, curvature and distortion. These are monochromatic aberrations. And coming to chromatic aberration, when white light is used in optical system, just you are observing in this slide, in the case of convex lens, this white light when the white light incidence on this convex lens, after refraction, the rays are not meet at one point, so the image is not clear. The image, because due to even the after incidenting, the rays are split into their constant colors. In these colors, violet rays are meet nearer to the lens, whereas red color rays farther to the lens. So we get two colored images, that is that violet color image here you are observing. This is violet color image and this is red color image. This is a focal length of this violet color image, and similarly this is the focal length of red color image, that is FV and FR, and remaining colors meet in between these two colors. So different images are formed. So totally the image is blurred with different colors, multi colors. It is chrome of colors. So that's what that this aberration is known as a chromatic aberration. In this case of this convex lens, this chromatic aberration is taken as a positive. Whereas you are observing if you take a concave lens, in this concave lens, this is a divergent lens. Here also, this violet color is nearer to the lens, so and a red color image is farther to the lens. But here, the chromatic aberration is taken as a negative for this concave lens. This is the condition. This is the in case of convex lens and in case of concave lens, how this chromatic aberration is formed. After the understanding of this one, let us calculate the chromatic aberration. That is chromatic aberration, the measurement, how we measure this chromatic aberration is nothing but the difference between the focal length of red color image to the violet color image, that is FR minus FP is known as a this is also known as a longitudinal chromatic aberration. So let us clearly know about this longitudinal chromatic aberration. Just observe this figure, observe this slide. Here you are observing, this is again a lens system. Here this is the object. This is the object, AB is the object. The rays which are coming from this object incident on this lens system. After getting refraction, the violet color rays meet at this point and a red color rays meet at this point. Different colors meet at different points in between these two colors. So therefore the image formed with blur, different colors. So here the difference between on the principal axis, this is the principal axis, this is known as the difference between the focal lengths of these two images, red color image and violet color image, is known as a longitudinal chromatic aberration. Whereas this your height, the differences between this is known as a lateral chromatic aberration. So this is longitudinal and this is the lateral. So let us calculate the longitudinal chromatic aberration for the lens system or optical system. For that purpose, let us when a parallel beam of white light is incident on a convex lens, just now we have taken that figure, you assume here our aim is to calculate the differences between the focal lengths, that is FR minus FP. So for that purpose, let us assume FP is the focus for the violet rays and FR is the focus for red rays. Okay. Similarly, the difference between, that is the distance, FR minus FP is equal to X, is called as a longitudinal aberration. Just now we have seen in that slide. So that is FR minus F. According to our knowledge, lens maker formula, by using lens maker formula, that is 1 by F is equal to mu minus 1, 1 by R1 minus 1 by R2. Here, mu is the refractive index of the material of that lens and R1, R2 are the radius of curvature of two surfaces. So that is R1, R2. By this equation, we can write this 1 by R1, here this one, 1 by R1 minus 1 by R2 is equal to 1 by F into mu minus 1. Similarly, for violet rays, this equation, fourth equation, comes as mu V minus 1 into 1 by R1 minus 1 by R2. This can be written as mu v minus 1 in place of 1 by r1 minus 1 by r2, we can write 1 by f into mu minus 1 by seeing fifth equation. So totally 1 by fp is equal to, we get mu v minus 1 by f into mu minus 1. This is the equation for violet color rays. Similarly, for red color rays, the equation comes as 1 by FR is equal to mu R minus 1 into 1 by R1 minus 1 by R2. So, next 1 by next 1 by F 1 by FR is equal to mu R minus 1 into 1 by R1 minus 1 by R2. Next, 1 by FR is equal to in place of 1 by R1 minus 1 by R2. Again, substituting this 1 by F into mu minus 1, we get mu R minus 1 by F into mu minus 1. So, this is the same. Means by 6 and 7 equations, what we have calculated until now is, we have calculated the this 1 by FR value, 1 by FP value for two different colors. Let us difference these equations, that is 1 by FP minus 1 by FR, that is we are subtracting these two equations, mu R minus mu V minus 1 by f into this equation. Mu v minus 1 by f into mu minus 1 minus mu r minus 1 by f into mu minus 1. By taking LCM f into mu minus 1, mu v minus 1 minus mu r plus 1, 1 gets cancelled. The remaining by in left hand side also, if we simplify, we get f r minus v f r minus f p by f p f r is equal to mu v minus mu r by f into mu minus 1. Here f r f p, here say that is f is the mean focal length of that 7 colors, that is f f r must be equal to f, f p also must be equal to, then f r f p can be written as f square. So substituting these values, f r minus f p by f square mu v minus mu r by f into mu minus 1. Next step, f r minus f p is equal to mu v minus mu r by mu minus 1 into f. After that, we have already know that dispersive power. Dispersive power is nothing but omega is equal to d mu by mu minus 1. So substituting these values, similarly this mu v minus mu r by mu minus 1 must be equal to dispersive power. So f r minus f p is equal to omega into f. This is nothing but longitudinal chromatic aberration. This is the equation for calculation for longitudinal chromatic aberration. So this, that means what we understand from this equation is the axial chromatic aberration of a lens equal to the mean focal, its mean focal length multiplied by the dispersive power of material of the lens. This simply it is the product of omega and f. Next, after understanding this chromatic aberration and measurement of this chromatic aberration, let us think about the elimination methods. Can we minimize this chromatic aberration? So let us discuss about minimization or elimination of this chromatic aberration. This is known as achromatism, or this is also known as achromatic doublet. The achromatism is nothing but the process of removal of chromatic aberration. A lens system which is free from chromatic aberration. So that is known as a achromatism. Here, just already we have discussed about this slide. Just again remind that one. That is, here see, a convex lens forms the, in this convex lens, a convex lens forms the image of violet color closer to the, this is the violet color and this is red color. Violet color closer to the lens than the red color. Okay, is it? But in case of concave lens, see here, in this case also, the violet color also nearer to the lens than red color. This is the violet color, this is the red color. But what happens if we combine these two lenses like this? This. If we combine these two lenses, what happens? This is, by the comparison of these two cases, although violet color is focused nearer to the lenser in both cases, here in this case, violet color, in the case of convex lens, the violet color falls left to the red color. Here, this is red color, this is left. Whereas in case of a concave lens, the violet color image falls right to the red color. So that is, so violet color falls to the left of red color in case of convex lens, whereas in case of concave lens, it falls right to the red color. So this is the case we observe. So if we combine these two lenses like this, this one, if we combine, this is a convex lens and this is a concave lens. If we combine, what happens? the total system, this lens system, the new system that is known as a achromatic doublet. This new system is free from the chromatic aberration. This is known as a achromatic doublet. This is a combination of convex lens and a concave lens is known as a achromatic doublet. Let us know the what are the conditions, how we combine those two lenses. See here, this is actual achromatic doublet. This is the this is the concave lens and this is the convex lens. This convex lens also some dispersive power and it has some focal length. This is also for concave lens also it has some focal length and the dispersive power. So this is known as a achromatic doublet. Here this is to achieve a good achromatic doublet, a crown gloss. Here this is the crown gloss. This convex lens should be made with the crown gloss material, whereas concave lens made with the flint gloss material. For this flint gloss material, the for this concave lens, it should have greater focal length than the convex lens. Means whereas convex lens with crown gloss has low focal length, the concave lens which is made with the flint gloss has greater focal length. This is a achromatic doublet. Let us the two cases how we combine these two lenses. So this achromatism or achromatization is used in two different cases. These are when the two lenses are in contact. This one. See here, when the two lenses are in contact, two lenses in contact mean just now this is the convex lens, this is the concave lens. Next, when two lenses here, this second one, when the two lenses are separated by some distance, so if you take two convex lenses, some distance by placing, these two are called as a achromatic doublet. Whereas this is in contact, this is in this case there is a some distance between these two lenses. So these are the two types of achromatisms in the optical system to remove the chromatic aberration. So here for the first case, when the two lenses are in contact, this type of achromatic doublets are used in the microscope and telescope as objectives. Coming to the second one, when the two lenses are separated by distance, this type of achromatism is used in the eyepieces of optical instruments. These are the uses of this achromatization. So let us discuss one by one that case. That is, condition for achromatism of two lenses in contact. So this is the in contact. This is the achromatism. For this purpose, let us derive a condition how we achromatize these two lenses. For that purpose, let us consider an expression for the focal length f of a thin lens. We are considering the thin lenses. The equation of a lens is nothing but this one. 1 by f is equal to mu minus 1 into 1 by r1 minus 1 by r2. Here, mu is the refractive index of the lens. R1 and R2 are the radius of curvature of the two surfaces. If you consider this one, this is R1 and this is R2. So here our aim is to eliminate the differences in focal lengths. So just to calculate the change in the focal length. For that purpose, the variations are focal length and the refractive index. So the change in focal length corresponding to a change in the refractive can be obtained by differentiating this equation. Just to calculate the change in the focal length. So differentiating this eighth equation, we get derivation of 1 by f must be equal to d mu, this equation, d mu into 1 by r1 minus 1 by r2. Dividing this ninth equation, this equation, by eighth equation, we get f into d into 1 by f is equal to d mu by mu minus 1. Therefore, next step, d into derivation of 1 by f is equal to d mu by mu minus 1 into 1 by f. But already we know that this d mu by mu minus 1 is nothing but dispersive power of the lens. On substituting, by substituting this in equation, we get this equation. Derivation of 1 by f is equal to omega by f. Next, another step we have to take, that is combination. We are talking about this combination. So, what is the combination, focal length of this combination? Just this equation. This equation we have to take. That is 1 by f is equal to 1 by f1 plus 1 by f2. By differentiating, we get again, what is the change in the focal length? Derivation of 1 by f is equal to derivation of 1 by f1 plus derivation of 1 by f2. But already we know that derivation of 1 by f1 is nothing but omega 1 by omega 2. Omega 1 by f1. So, derivation of 1 by f2 is equal to, we can write omega 2 by f2. So, on substituting this in above equation, we get derivation of 1 by f is equal to omega 1 by f1 plus omega 2 by f2. Here, for combination to be achromatic, change in focal length should be 0. So, that is derivation of 1 by f must be equal to 0. On substituting, the equation changes into omega 1 by f1 plus omega 2 by f2 is equal to 0. Therefore, f1 by f2 can be written as, sorry here, one mistake here, that is omega 2 minus omega 1 by omega 2. Just change this one in place of f2. Just write omega 2. So that is. Next, if omega 1 is equal to omega 2, what happens? Just see. That is omega into 1 by f1 plus 1 by f2 is equal to 0. But as here, omega does not equal to 0. Here, that is omega does not equal to 0. Therefore, 1 by f1 plus 1 by f2 must be equal to 0. That means total combination of focal length also 0. That implies f should be infinite. That means if omega, what is the meaning of this equation, this f is equal to infinite means, if omega 1 and omega 2 are equal, if the dispersive powers of two, the convex lens and concave lenses are equal, the combination behaves like a plain glass bit. That is, focal length is infinite is nothing but this is for plain glass. So, the combination behaves like a plain glass plate. So, therefore, omega 1 never be equal to omega 2. Omega 1 and omega 2 should not be equal, which means that the lenses should be different materials. That's what we use, a crown material and plint glass material. So, hence, if one is crown glass lens, the other lens must be plint glass. Here, the dispersive power of crown glass is less than dispersive power of plint glass. And here in the equation we are getting here, that is minus. Minus sign indicates that the two lenses must be opposite sign in achromatic doublet. That is, if one is convex lens, other should be concave lens. That is a lens combination which satisfies this condition. That is, that condition means that is omega 1 by omega 2 is equal to minus f1 by f2. That is called this condition. The lens combination which satisfies this condition is known as a achromatic doublet. So this is about achromatization when two lenses are in contact. So that is next. Similarly, let us discuss condition of achromatism of two thin lenses separated by some finite distance. So for this purpose, let us consider two thin lenses having focal lengths, that is f1 and f2. This is f1 and f2 are separated by a distance x here. Similarly, two lenses are made with the same material, that is dispersive powers. Omega 2 is equal to, that is omega 1 is equal to omega 2 is equal to omega. So next, after assuming this system, the combined focal length of for these two lenses can be written as 1 by f is equal to 1 by f1 plus 1 by f2 minus x by f1 f2. Next, let us calculate the change in focal length. So that for that purpose, differentiating this equation, we get derivation of 1 by f is equal to derivation of 1 by f1 plus derivation of 1 by f2 minus derivation of x by f1 f2. See here. After doing this derivation part, see here, that is derivation of 1 by f is equal to omega 1 by f1 plus omega 2 by f2 minus x by f2. Derivation of this 1 by f1 can be written as omega 1 by f1, because already we know derivation of 1 by f is equal to omega f. So we are substituting these values. Similarly, in this case also, for combination to be achromatism, the focal length should not change with color. Change in focal length will be 0. So derivation of 1 by f must be equal to 0. Just put the equate the right hand side as a 0, that is, or left hand also 0. We get this equation. On simplification, omega 1 by f1 plus omega 2 by f2 is equal to x into omega 1 plus omega 2 by f1 f2. Therefore, the distance must be equal to this one. X is equal to omega 1 f2 plus omega 2 f1 by omega 1 plus omega 2. In this case, first we have assumed that omega 1 is equal to omega 2 is equal to omega. That means two lenses are made up with same material. Substitute that condition. So then the equation changes into x is equal to omega f2 plus omega f1 by omega plus omega. By omega omega getting cancelled, we get the distance as x is equal to f1 plus f2 by 2. So this is, if the two thin lenses which we have assumed placed at a finite distance must, that is equal to average distance of their focal length, then the combination should be eliminate the achromatic aberration. So achromatic combination, two lenses should be separated by a distance equal to average of their focal length. These are the methods for eliminating of this chromatic aberration. These are the two methods. So let us try to solve problem depending upon this chromatic average. See here, the dispersive powers of the dispersive powers of the crown and flint glosses are 0.2, here not 0-2, 0.2 and 0.4 respectively. Then he is asking, find the focal lengths of the components of an achromatic doublet of focal length 20 centimeters. Simply, how we solve this problem? See, achromatic, this is the problem based upon the achromatic doublet. Suppose say F1, F2 are the focal lengths of this crown and this one. Say this F1 and F2 are the focal lengths of crown and flint glass, and capital F is the combination of focal length of combination. Then if you use this formula, that is F1 by F2 is equal to omega 1 by omega 2. This is the condition for achromatization of two lenses in contact. So F1 can be written as minus F2 into omega 1 by omega 2. Substitute the given values, minus F2 into 0.2 by 0.4, that is F2 by 2. Combination focal length formula just used, 1 by 20 is equal to, substituting these values, minus 2 by F2 plus 1 by F2. You get an equation like this. On solving these two equations, you get F2 is equal to 10 centimeters. F2 is equal to 10 centimeters. Sorry, F2 is equal to 10 centimeters. Here also one mistake. Then F1 is equal to 10 centimeters and F2 is equal to 20 centimeters. This is the, we get F1 is equal to 10 centimeters, F2 is equal to minus 20 centimeters. This is the problem. Similarly, let us do another problem. That is, calculate the focal length. Calculate the focal length of a lens of dispersive power 0.45, which should be placed in contact with a convex lens of focal length 84 centimeters and dispersive power omega is equal to 0.21 to make the achromatic combination. This is also contact condition. So that is, simply use this condition, omega 1 by F1 is equal to, sorry, omega 1 by F1 plus omega 2 by F2 is equal to 0. Given data, omega 1 given, omega 2 given, F2, F1. Just substitute these values in this equation, you get the focal length of F1. Calculate the focal length. This is the focal length, that is 180 centimeters. Next, another problem. This is based on the calculation of longitudinal chromatic aberration. See here. The focal length of a lens made up crown gloss is 20 centimeters. Then find the longitudinal chromatic aberration if mu b is equal to 1.53, that is refractive index of blue color, and refractive index of red color is equal to 1.52. To do this, we need, what is the formula, how we calculate the chromatic, longitudinal chromatic aberration, that is FR minus FB. Our concentration is on this formula only. So, for this purpose, just the refractive index of yellow color, that is mu y, because to calculate dispersive power, we need that is mean of this refractive index, that is mu y is equal to mu b plus average of these two colors, mu b plus mu r by 2, that is 1.53 plus 1.52 by 2, that is we get mu y is equal to 1.525. therefore, after getting this this refractive index mean, dispersive power is nothing but that is d mu by mu minus 1. So the difference of refractive index by mu minus 1, that is 0.01 by 0.525. we get omega is equal to 0.019. next, therefore longitudinal chromatic aberration is the product of dispersive power and the focal length. So that is delta f, it is nothing but fr minus fb, can be calculated as 0 omega into f, 0.019 into f, that is focal length, that is given, that is 20 centimeters from the focal length. So that is 0.38 centimeters is the chromatic aberration for this problem. These are the problems which are based on today's class. How to calculate the chromatic aberration, how to find the focal length, dispersive powers, and different types of achromatic doublet system. In this class, let us recall what we have learnt. That is, in this class, we have calculated the longitudinal chromatic aberration. So that is because longitudinal chromatic aberration, how we calculate that one here, this is the log, this is fr minus fv is the longitudinal chromatic aberration. It is the product of dispersive power and the focal length of the lens. So this is the calculation. Next, let us minimization of chromatic aberration, elimination methods. By combining these convex lens and concave lens, we can eliminate the chromatic aberrations, because for convex lens system, this chromatic aberration should be taken as a positive. For this concave lens system, this chromatic aberration taken as a negative. So if we combine, they cancels to each other, so the lens system, the combination system, will be free from the chromatic aberration. For that purpose, there are two, this is the achromatic doublet system, this is known as achromatic doublet. Generally we use convex lens is made up with crown gloss, which is less low focal length, and we use concave lens of flint glass with a greater focal length. There are two methods, two different cases for achromatic doublet. When the two lenses are in contact, this type of achromatism is used in microscope and telescope. Similarly, another combination, that is when the two lenses are separated by a distance, this type of chromatic doublet is used in eyepieces of the optical instruments. This is the achromatic doublet system. If we combine these two lenses like this, the condition must be equal to omega 1 by omega 2. Here, just write down in place of F2 as a omega 2. This is wrongly then here, minus omega 1 by omega 2. Here this implies that minus symbol indicates that one should be convex and the other should be concave. So that two lenses should be prepared with different materials. If we select a crown, and other should be plain like that. So That is the condition for achromatic doublet, which when the system is in contact. Next, a condition for achromatism of two thin lenses separated by a finite distance. For this purpose, this is the system we have assumed here. You are observing. For this system, if we solve for the distance, how much distance we have to place those two lenses, that must be equal to the average of these their focal lengths. That is, x is equal to f1 plus f2 by 2. So that is the how we derive this formula. Just we have taken the combination, that is focal length of this combination, that is 1 by f is equal to 1 by f1 plus 1 by f2 minus x by f1 f2. After writing this formula, we differentiate this equation, we get second equation. After that, differentiation of 1 by f can be written as omega f. Therefore, differentiation of 1 by f1 can be written as omega 1 by f1. Similarly, differentiation of 1 by f2 is equal to omega 2 by f2. Substituting this equation in this one, derivation of 1 by f is equal to omega 1 by f1 plus omega 2 by f2 minus x by f2 into omega 1 by f1 minus x by f1 into omega 2 by f2. For combination should be achromatic, the change in focal length must be 0. Equate this one to 0, we get this equation omega 1 by f1 plus omega 2 by f2 minus x into omega 1 plus omega 2 by f1 minus f2 is equal to 0. Or if we solve for the x distance, x is equal to omega 1 f2 plus omega 2 f1 by omega 1 plus omega 2. If the two lenses are made with same material, the dispersive powers should be equal. Omega 1 is equal to omega 2 is equal to omega. Substituting by eliminating this, by cancelling this omega, we get finally x is equal to f1 plus f2 by 2. If we place these two lenses to the at a distance which is equal to the average of their focal lengths, then the system should be free from the achromatic aberration. So these are the two elimination methods. So this is about today's class. In this class, that is measurement of longitudinal chromatic aberration and elimination methods. Some problems based on this one we discussed in this class. Okay.